performance of the organization, not increasing sales. That's very important. When you do strategic marketing, the issue is not whether you are increasing sales. The issue is whether your organization is performing. Are we together this way? Hallelujah. Rubbish. Yeah? So you need to, we need to move from this idea that we are not increasing sales. When I was in the private sector, they would tell us that Mary have given you, we used to have big budgets. And we used to use an advertising agency called TAC. I don't know if the TAC is still there in S.C. Johnson. They are still there. And the bosses would always tell us, we've given you billions, we are not seeing sales. Now I know it is not necessary that you're increasing sales. Now, as you do your marketing strategies as a strategic marketer, it is important for you to have innovative business models. How innovative are you as a marketing person is very, very important. How creative are you is very, very important. Yeah? Understand your market, understand your competitors, then come up with an innovative business model. And then you must also ensure that you have what we call in strategy distinctive capabilities that match the requirements of your customer so that you can be superior. Remember we say that customers are more knowledgeable today. You'll come and sell to me something and I'll tell you, no, I think this one is better than yours. What do you say? So you've got to come up with an innovative model. So strategic marketers must regularly carry out strategic situational analysis. Yeah? Strategic, don't do SWOT analysis. By the way, these days it's called SCOT analysis. C standing for? Simupate hiyo ni mpe bugi ya guri. Ate C stands for? Guy. Haya, wacha nimalize. Why strategic situational analysis is important? It helps you to identify your opportunities, define your segments, evaluate your competition, assess your strengths and your challenges. And therefore, it is important. What I'm saying here is that when you talk about strategic marketing, really, you need to define where you want to compete. You see, someone said that you cannot be everything to everyone. And I think that's another problem with marketers. They want to be everything to everyone. You've got to define what is your competitive arena and who are your key competitors, those that are going, you know, after the same market target that you have. That is what we call a strategic situational analysis. Yeah? Where am I going to compete? Sometimes you don't need to compete with, actually you don't have to compete with everyone, but you need to appreciate that they're your competitors. But you need to ensure that you evaluate who are your key competitors. And then very important, a strategic marketer always anticipates the key actions of their competitors. For example, there is a time Airtel decided to reduce the price. What did Safaricom do? Some years back. They actually reduced to a point where Airtel could not reduce further. You don't, strategic marketers anticipate. You don't do something which you know that when your key competitor hits back, you are finished. It is like the case of Goliath and who? But now the other way around. Without the anointing. With anointing is different. But imagine a David with no anointing and a Goliath with no anointing. I mean, angemchukua tu hivi sio? Anamweka chini, anamkanyaga, anaishia. Yeah? So you need to ensure that you anticipate the key actions. Now, almost finally, most organizations do not have any strategic plan. Rather, then jump from idea to idea. Like you go, you hear an idea somewhere and say, I think that can work, eh? That can work in our company. You have no plan at all. In other words, you need to plan before you enter the marketplace. However, we are saying that the environment is dynamic. Yes, it is dynamic, but you must have a plan which you keep on evaluating and monitoring at all times and change where necessary. So it does not mean because the environment is dynamic, you don't have a plan. You know, I've heard Kenyans say that, you know, hivi tu ina change kila saa, kuna aje ya mpango. Unagoja tu, unaangalia, unaona vile inaenda ni hivi unafanya. Inajipanga, vitu gravi imesorwa, you know, kind of thing. Now, a strategic marketer has a plan before they enter the marketplace. And then they keep on evaluating that plan and monitoring that plan and change where necessary. Now, just as I said earlier, tactical marketing is what most of us are doing. But with tactical marketing only, the impact is not likely to be high. So it is always important to have both a strategy and a tactic. And different strategies in terms of marketing will work for different stages of your product life cycle. For example, if you are at the development stage of your product, visionary strategic plans will work. If you are at the growth stage, then you become more strategic, at maturity, operational. When products are declining, then you do strategic marketing that is cost management. Have anything you have said that you have been taught in class so far so that I know how to finish? Hello? The product life cycle only. I'm doing well. Now, strategic marketing links the organization with the environment in which it operates in. And therefore, in strategic marketing, the responsibility is the entire business rather than a specialized function. In other words, you cannot be an organization that says they deal with strategic marketing and then they have a specific person to do that. Strategic marketing views marketing as a responsibility of the business. The way you do things is marketing. The way people speak to everyone, when you go to finance and you want to be paid, the way the finance person is speaking is marketing. Are we together? When I come to your office and the way the tea girl gives me tea, it's marketing. It's part of strategic marketing. So strategic marketing views marketing as the responsibility of the entire business, not a specialized function. And therefore, there is need to link your marketing with business performance. And the reason why many of us have problems convincing CEOs why you should be given money is because sometimes we are not able to defend what we do. Am I right? If someone asks you, I've given you 10 million this year, can you tell me how you are giving brochures, how your billboard, how your bus shelter has increased sales? Can you tell that? What do you normally do? Eh? Talk to me, marketers. I'm finishing. This is my second last slide. Eh? How do you justify your budget in the boardroom? As a marketing person, something tangible, like numbers, ROI, return on investment. Oh, and if you are not selling, how will you measure awareness? And I can see you know these things. Now, you can easily justify your marketing budget in the boardroom using various measurements from a strategic marketing point. One of the above three, customer focused indicators, are you retaining customers? Are you satisfying customers? It is a measure of whether you are actually strategically marketing. You see, there are some companies you go to and you don't go back again. Not because they have even put any advert or any, just the way they have treated you, you're like, I'm not interested in this organization. You can also use competitor-centered indicators. For example, market share. These are the ones that most bosses understand, sales growth. But you can also do internally oriented indicators, like he's saying awareness, number of customer complaints, number of new products. Remember we said strategic marketing, the key issue is you must have innovation. So you can measure your strategic marketing using these major things because of time. Finally, if your strategic marketing plan does not work, consider changing the plan, not the goal. Are we together? Every marketer must have a goal. If you realize that your plan is not working, then don't change the goal. Don't start saying, "Ay, we were very ambitious. Mudos, ay, tulikuwa ambitious sana. Wajua tulikuwa tunafikiria hii sales itakuwa mingi." No, no. You know I have been there, so I know, eh? No, you know marketers are very, I like the way we talk, and it is true, by the way. You know, marketers are very optimistic. You know, even now, I don't tell you you're going to sell. Surely, you know it is bad. But actually, I've realized, now with the twanging aspect, I've now realized, you know, no, don't change your goal. Probably, the problem is your plan. Oh, thank you very much for listening to me.